Okay, so in this problem, we are told the predominant frequency of a certain fire truck siren is 1,350 hertz when at rest. What frequency do you detect if you move with a speed of 30 meters per second, A, toward the truck, and B, away from it? So in this problem, we're basically given two scenarios for A and B. So I'll call scenario 1 A and scenario 2 is B. So in both scenarios, we have a fire truck that's going to be at rest. Emitting a frequency of 1,350 hertz. And then the difference between the two problems is we, as the observer, we can imagine the car as us, the observer. We're either going to be traveling towards the truck at 30 meters per second or away from it at 30 meters per second. And what we're trying to find is the frequency that we, the car, right? Imagine us as the car, is going to observe if we're going towards it or away from it. So in order to solve this, we're going to use the Doppler effect formulas. And so the formula for these are going to be different depending on whether we're approaching the object or going away from the object. So there's two formulas. So I'll write them out for A and B. So the formula for if you're the observer approaching or going towards the stationary source that's emitting, you can calculate the frequency. We call it F prime. That's what the book uses. So I'll use that. One plus the velocity of the observer divided by the velocity of sound. Multiplied by frequency. And so the only thing that changes for this is the positive sign. So it's only the minus sign right there is what changes. So notice if you're going away, you have a negative there. If you have a positive, you're going towards it. So that's an important distinction to make. It's pretty easy to memorize because if you're going towards it, we know that the frequency is going to increase, while if you go away from it, it's going to decrease. So let's go over this for A. So what is the velocity of the observer? So in both cases, we're the observer in this car moving 30 meters per second. So for both of these, it's just going to be 30 meters per second there. Velocity of sound is a number you should just have memorized. So the velocity of sound is equal to 343 meters per second. So that's for both of them. And then F is the frequency of your stationary object, right? So the frequency of our fire truck here is 1,350 hertz. So notice we really just have everything. It's just a matter of plugging it in here. So once you know these formulas, this problem is pretty easy. So we have 1 plus the velocity of our observer, which we said was 30, plus 343 multiplied by 1,350. So we'll figure that out in a second. Let me write it out for this one too. So we have 1 plus 30 over 343 multiplied by 1,350. Or sorry, this isn't plus. I don't know why I wrote plus. It's minus. Minus. Right, don't make that mistake. So minus here, plus there. So let's go ahead and see what these are. So 330 divided by 343 plus 1 times 1350. So I got 1,468.08. Keep in mind this is frequency, so we have hertz here. Let's go figure out what this one is now. So 30 divided by 343, 1 minus that. Right, notice this one does decrease. So this one is going to be 1,231.92. So we can round both of these to the whole number. So F is going to be 1,468 hertz. Keep in mind that this one is for A. Now for B, right, this is B. We'll just say 1,232. Keep in mind frequency, this is hertz. And yeah, so your answers for both these are going to be right here, the frequencies that they're going to observe, right? So keep in mind it's dependent on this velocity of our observer, right? So that's going to change it. If this was zero, right? Notice if they were just both stationary, this would be zero, meaning this would be one times the frequency, it wouldn't change. So what's changing it here is the velocity of our observer, right? But it changes if we're going away, obviously it's going to decrease, which makes sense. And if we're going towards it, it's going to increase. So main takeaway from this problem is just memorizing these formulas here, right? You're going to use them a lot in this, using the Doppler effect, right? This chapter here. And then, yeah, just kind of understanding what's going on here is also important. So always good to draw a picture. And then it's just a matter of plugging it in. But yeah, so these right here are going to be your answers. And hopefully you found this video useful.